So far, we've had no need for the normal distribution. We've been able to answer our questions somewhat easily using simulation and randomization techniques. This is going to change pretty soon, however, since simulating data can be kind of non-trivial. And by that I mean very, very difficult. Instead, we use the normal distribution and the normal probability calculators, and later other distributions, to offer a general framework that applies to a very large number of settings. So for one example, the opportunity cost study determined that students are thriftier if they are reminded that saving money now means they can spend money later. The study's point estimate for the estimated impact was 20%, meaning 20% fewer students would move forward with a DVD purchase in this study scenario. However, point estimates aren't perfect, in that they only give you an estimate or approximation of the truth. It would be useful if we could provide a range of plausible values for the impact, more formally known as a confidence interval. It is often difficult to construct a reliable confidence interval in many situations using randomization and simulations. However, doing so is reasonably straightforward using the normal distribution. In fact, we'll see it in a couple more lessons.